Welcome back to Legit Street Cars. My name is Alex, and this is my 1999 Chevy Corvette. It was super cheap, has a ton of miles on it, and unfortunately, it was stored outside for the last 8 years. If you want to know more about the Corvette, check out the reveal video, which will be linked in the video description box down below. Now, my C5 has seen better days, and there are a few areas of this car that could use some attention. So over the course of 4 days for me, and just one video for you guys, I'm going to restore, replace and protect various parts of this car, all with the hopes of making one of my 90s childhood dream cars look amazing but on a budget. Everything will be tallied up towards the end of the video, so make sure to stick around. Now, my first order of business was removing the completely faded mirrors to have them painted by my body shop, Mancuso Auto Art in Glenview, Illinois, who are also going to town on my C63 AMG. Now, even with me dropping all of the mirror nuts into the Bermuda Triangle of doors, this job only took me 2 minutes and 34 seconds per side, thanks to GM only using 2 screws and a few clips to hold the door panel in. I'm also dropping off these nasty wiper arms to get painted the factory satin black, and the reason I'm doing this in the middle of the body shop parking lot is because I couldn't find my wiper arm puller, so let's hope it doesn't rain on my way home.
I really gotta get home. Worst timing ever.
When I got home, I almost immediately found the wiper arm puller, of course, so it was time for step one of surface preparation, since we're going to be ceramic coating almost every exterior surface of this car. I'll be using the Armor Shield 9 ceramic coating kit from a company called Avalon King, and I've used their kit on a few of my cars over the last 2 years. A ceramic coating forms a strong invisible shield that anyone can apply to almost every exterior surface of a car, whether it's the paint, the headlights, the glass, or the wheels. The coating fills the pores of the surface, protecting it from practically anything, including paint fading, UV damage, water, dirt, and my favorite, bird crap.
Silly birds, you think you can get through my ceramic coating? I don't think so. Oh, some more over here. Gone.
This ceramic coating can last up to 5 years, and not only is it very hydrophobic, but it also adds a deep glossy finish to your paint. I coated half of the hood on my daily driver Mercedes diesel 6 months ago, and it still repels dirt and water like the day I applied it, which makes it perfect for daily driver cars you don't want to wash all the time. There'll be links down below in the description box to all the products, parts, and tools you see in today's video, but I'll also leave you guys a coupon code that will get you your very own Armor Shield 9 ceramic coating kit for only $45. Now, if your paint is free of contamination and big scratches, you can simply apply the ceramic coating similar to wax and be done with it. But considering the condition of the Corvette, we need to start with a thorough wash. And for this, I'm using the Avalon King Prep Kit, which is sold as an add-on to the ceramic coating kit, and it includes your car wash solution, a wash mitt, a clay mitt, and a prep solution, which I'll cover when we ceramic coat the new wheels. After a really good rinse, I made some bubbles in a bucket and loaded the included car wash solution into my foam cannon, and I went to town making sure to cover everything. I'm not going to give you a full tutorial on how to wash your car, but after covering the whole car in suds, I used a two-bucket method to rinse my wash mitt after cleaning a section of the car so to not contaminate my soapy water with dirt, and yes, that Montero in the background looks like it's painted the same color as the vet, so comment away, people, comment away. At this point, I dried the Corvette and use this on the entire car. I accidentally didn't hit the record button on the camera for this part, but I sprayed an iron removing product on the whole Corvette, including the glass, and I let it sit for about 4 minutes. Then I spent about 5 minutes rinsing it all off. This does what it says. It removes iron particles so you don't grind them into the paint during polishing. Next, I sprayed the car back down with a light mist of car wash foam in preparation for the clay mitt. A clay mitt does exactly what a clay bar does, which is remove dirt and particles embedded in the pores of the clear coat, so again, you don't swirl this stuff into the clear coat during polishing. The mitt just does this a lot quicker than the clay bar. This step took me maybe 15 minutes, including the glass, and you can clean and reuse this mitt on dozens of other cars before it needs to be replaced. Now, hindsight is always 20/20, and it would have made more sense to do this first, but I then jacked up the car and removed the wheels to clean the brakes and wheel wells before installing the new wheels. These Chrome Z06 wheels are pitted and pretty nasty, and I don't want them anywhere near the garage when we go to polish and ceramic coat the car. I simply removed a wheel, sprayed the IronX product liberally, and then went to town with a few brushes to clean the calipers. With the brake calipers looking pretty decent, I used an old sponge to clean the wheel wells and then blasted it all away. I ceramic coated the barrels of the wheels the day before so they'd be dry and ready to be bolted up, and it's super easy to do this. You just clean the inner barrel with rubbing alcohol or the prep spray that comes in the Avalon King prep kit, and after that, you just apply the ceramic coating on a supplied applicator and wipe it on. Let it sit for a minute and buff it away with a clean microfiber. Wait at least 4 hours before handling the wheels and then go bolt them onto your car. We'll coat the spokes a little bit later in the video.
All right, I have to take a moment to admire the new wheels on the C5, and I gotta say, I love the simple design of the C6 five-spoke wheels. I think it gives the C5 just kind of like a modern refresh without going too crazy. I'd been considering the newer Z06 or ZR1 style wheels, and I just thought there was a little bit too much going on. So right now we got a ton of wheel gap, so this will settle as the suspension kind of lowers a little bit, and I think I'm gonna lower this car as well, but I love this look. They look a lot better than these, only due to their condition. I actually like the style of the Z06 wheels. There is my other LS based vehicle taking off. But I got these wheels from OE Wheels, and I've been buying wheels from them for well over a decade. Here is my Turbo Trans Am in a couple of magazines from about 10 years ago, rocking the C5 Chrome Z06 wheels. And now, of course, I bought a complete wheel and tire package from them with the C5 Y2K wheels and some BF Goodrich tires. And this is no different. So they sent me out a complete wheel and tire package, and they can include the TPC sensors as well if you have them, like the C5. And I made a video about this a few months back, but something you have to look out for when you're buying an aftermarket wheel is the DOT or SAE certification. There's a few others, but these are the best, and the wheels from OE Wheels all meet or exceed those certifications, and they stamp the wheel weight rating on the inside of each wheel, which is very, very important. So these guys have like 50 something thousand wheels in stock, ready to ship. Their customer service is awesome as well. So I'll leave a link to OE Wheels down below. But I am loving the wheels on my car. Now I gotta flip it around, do the other side, and then we're going in the garage for some polishing.
Once in the garage, I decided I didn't like the aftermarket mesh grills the previous owner installed, so I took them out along with the very loose black plastic trim pieces behind them. I've seen C5 Corvettes with these installed and without, but after some cleaning, I think it looks much better without anything in there. I also removed the fender mesh grills as well, and soon we'll be restoring all the black plastic trim, including the faded cowl. Before polishing, I cleaned out the channel under the hatch as it was pretty grimy, and then I cleaned the door jam area and the lower rocker panel area as well. I didn't want anything contaminating the polishing pad, so I used a liberal amount of rubbing alcohol and water, and then I just went ahead and did a light polish. This area was in good shape, so I didn't go too crazy, and it came out really nicely. I also cleaned up all the weather stripping seals, and I'm really glad that I did that.
All right, so I just got done wiping the entire Corvette down in rubbing alcohol, and she's ready for the paint correction. So right now, the car is taped up. I've covered up our new wheel, and we're gonna start off with the worst area of the car, which is definitely this rear deck lid. You can see our tape line from the reveal video and the area here that we polished out, so this is gonna look amazing when we're done. I also removed the rear Corvette emblem. I thought I was gonna be able to save this because two of the pieces had popped out and I found them, but it looked a little bit too raggedy, and then this way with this gone, I can polish out in between and really make this look brand new. So I've ordered a factory GM emblem that should be in tomorrow, actually. So you can see the huge difference in our faded paint and the new paint that was under the emblem. So very, very exciting stuff. Now here is our game plan. This is what we're going to be doing for the paint correction process. I'm going to do a two-step system. So we're going to start off
with our coarse wool pad, and we're using a Rupes Bigfoot polisher for this entire job. And we're gonna combine that with the coarse compound. After that, I'll wipe the entire car down in rubbing alcohol again, and then we're gonna finish her off with a fine foam pad and some fine polish. And something I learned in my last paint correction ceramic coating video on the C55 was to go a lot slower with this machine. I was moving it back and forth too quickly, so that is kind of my focus for today, is that I'm gonna be using this machine just a lot slower. I'm gonna be checking more often with my light just to make sure that the paint is up to snuff and it's to my liking. So our goal here is to get rid of all the oxidation and then of course any scratches that are in the Corvette. And I think overall this thing is just gonna look so cool when we're done. So anyway, with that said, I gotta get to work. I have a feeling I'm gonna spend probably 8 to 10 hours doing this, and this will just be a quick time lapse for you guys. Polishing with the wool pad felt very similar to polishing with a foam pad, but I found myself needing to clean the wool after finishing each section, so this took a long time. I'm recording this voiceover after I finished the entire car, so I can tell you now that I did spend a full 8 hours with the wool pad. I took my time and worked in smaller sections, making sure to partially overlap on each pass. I would wipe down each section after polishing, and I used my light to look for any scratches or remaining oxidation. Some parts of the car, like the flat deck lid, are easy and fun, but other parts, like the lower panels, the taillights, and the lettering, can be a total pain in the butt and take a really long time to make look nice. It's important not to stay in one spot too long, as you don't want to create too much heat and burn the paint, but with a really good quality pad and polisher, it's pretty hard to mess this up. At one point, even my boy helped out and things were looking pretty good.
All right, progress report. I have half of the hood done. This is the side that's finished. It is looking amazing. And then if we move over, it's not as drastic as the rear deck lid, but there are still a ton of impurities, contaminants in this clear coat that will come right out with our coarse wool pad and the coarse compound. So I'm not sure if you can see that stuff, but in person, this side looks a lot better, trust me.
Now, I did have to replace the wool pad once during this entire process, and after priming and buttering her up, it was right back at it. After I completed the first stage, we moved on to the fine foam pad and the fine polishing compound, and using the foam is a lot more forgiving and more comfortable as it's much thicker. Getting into tight areas was much easier too, but overall, this just took way less time, especially because the wool pad did such a good job at correcting the paint. I probably spent 4 hours with the foam pad and the process was literally the same, so let's just move on to restoring the plastic trim. Oh, and guys, I did adjust the headlight cover on the left side. So many of you had commented in the last video how off the body lines were around that cover, so here you go. For a 90s Corvette, this is as good as it gets. The black trim on the car was totally faded and really made the car look old, so it was time to restore it. I started by spraying all the black trim with rubbing alcohol and water, and then it was time to test out two different products that I bought on Amazon. I made my tape line and started with this stuff by a company called Trinova. You just put the product on the applicator pad and wipe it on. I did the same with the Meguiar's back to black and waited 1 minute. I then wiped them away with a clean microfiber, and here are the results. They pretty much do exactly the same thing, so pick whichever one you want, and even though I don't think this is gonna last forever, it's a big improvement. I finished up the cowl area, then moved on to the inner fenders, and then I also did the little corner trims on each side of the car. I tell you what, even if it fades again, this stuff is so easy to put on and it makes such a big difference that in my opinion, it's totally well worth it. If you guys know of any other trim restoration tricks, please make sure to comment down below. With the trim looking pretty sweet, it was time to ceramic coat the entire car. I wiped the whole Corvette down, including the glass, with rubbing alcohol and water one more time, and this is to make sure that any compound residue is removed so our coating has a clean surface to adhere to. Since this step is super important, I also used the Prep Kit's Prep Spray, which further cleans the surface, and I started by cleaning off the entire hood. Then you just wrap the supplied black cloth around the applicator pad, apply about 5 drops of coating to said cloth, and wipe it on a 2x2 section at a time. Make sure you cover the entire area and then just wait 60 seconds. After that, just gently wipe away with a microfiber to remove excess coating and move on to the next section. Make sure you overlap slightly so you know that the entire area is covered, and you'll repeat this on literally anything you want to coat. One trick to make this go a little bit quicker is to coat two separate sections at a time. By the time you finish coating the second section, you'll be ready to wipe away the first section with your microfiber, and by the time you're done wiping the first section away, you're ready to wipe the excess coating from the second section, if that makes any sense to you at all. One little bottle is enough to coat an entire car, and since the Corvette is small, I'll definitely have leftovers. I've used this ceramic coating kit on 5 cars now, and it's pretty awesome. This stuff can actually be kind of addicting as it protects everything it touches so well. After coating the glass, you'll use your wipers a lot less and the glass will stay much cleaner. And after coating the wheels, you'll notice they'll stay cleaner a lot longer since dirty rainwater and brake dust gets repelled right off. You want to wait at least 4 hours before touching any coated surface and about 12 hours before driving the car, but the longer the better as far as drying time goes. With the entire car coated and 12 hours of drying time, I then installed my new Corvette emblem in the back. It's pretty cool that you can still buy this kind of stuff from GM, and since it's held on with double-sided tape, it's a very easy install. Next was a quick stop to Mancuso's, where I started by reinstalling my freshly painted satin black wiper arms, and just take a look at the end results. With a restored cowl and painted arms, this part of the car looks amazing and for cheap. Our final step was the reinstallation of the side mirrors. Since these are just about the easiest things in the world to do on a C5, I was done in about 4.5 minutes. Okay, that's a lie. The video clip frame from in front of the door was like 1:20, but I still think that I beat GM's book time on this job. The exterior of the Corvette is now totally done, and even though I ended up spending 4 long days on this and another 2 days editing this video, it was totally worth it. Just in the drive to the forest preserve, I had 2 people compliment the car. One guy gave me the Corvette wave as he passed me in his C4 Corvette, and one guy in a suspicious looking van stopped me in the middle of filming this part of the video to tell me how much he liked the car, but that they're too expensive to fix. I just pretended to agree so he'd leave. We basically took a tired looking Corvette that resembled more of a neglected daily driver and turned it into something you'd be proud to take to your local car meet. Is this car totally mint? Not at all, but there are a few different levels to car restorations, and the next step for this car would be an expensive one. There are still rock chips in the paint, some scratches that wouldn't come out, and even some spider webbing and nicks in the bumpers, but to have this all repaired the right way, we're talking thousands of dollars in paint and bodywork, and considering the car has 137,000 miles and is totally mechanically sound, I think it's the perfect driver Corvette. It looks great from a few feet away, and you don't have to feel bad about driving this thing because of its little bumps and bruises. It was also pretty cheap, so let's break down what I have into this thing. The Corvette was $8,500. The wheels, tires, and tire pressure sensors were $1,400 shipped out the door, $200 to have the mirrors and wiper arms painted, $45 for the ceramic coating kit, and another $60 for the prep kit, and let's just say another $75 in compound, buffing pads, microfibers, and the plastic restoration stuff. Oh, and I spent $65 on the new Corvette emblem, so if my math is correct, we have $10,345 total into this Corvette. Considering what this car looks like, I don't think that's half bad. I still have a few little things to do, like the oil pressure switch and a headlight gear, for a grand total of maybe $40, and I may recover the seats for a couple hundred, but I think eventually I'll have about $11,000 total into a well-sorted C5 with brand new wheels and brand new tires. Can I turn a profit on this car? Maybe, but I love doing this stuff first and foremost, and I love Corvettes, and that's the most important thing. Let me know in the comments section what you guys think. Is this something you'd want to do, and what kind of car do you have in mind for a mini restoration? Thanks so much for watching. If you've been watching my videos for a while now and haven't subscribed yet, consider hitting that subscribe button. If you like the video, hit the like button, share the video with friends, and most importantly, have a great day. I'll catch you all next time.